Video preview.
Dreams stripped down beyond firelight and seeing things unreal and what comes crawling back again.
A new IP from developer id Software is the sort of thing that seems to only come once in a lifetime. The last one, a little first-person shooter known as Quake, was released in 1996. Do the math, that's over 15 years ago. So when the studio announced Rage in 2007, there was no small amount of excitement and anticipation about this new title. Introduced as a post-apocalyptic, open-world, first-person shooter, with a heavy emphasis on vehicle combat, there certainly seemed to be a lot of familiar ground for the Doom and Quake developer. There also seemed to be a pretty strong Mad Max vibe to it, a pretty compelling formula, to say the least.
Jackie Weeks, he's in the back of town. Can't miss him. Just look for the big inflatable gorilla.
The world of Rage should feel right at home to anyone who's ever had their home destroyed by a giant meteorite. What was once a glimmering spectacle at the peak of civilization, the world of Rage was snuffed out when an asteroid came hurtling from the sky. Those who could sought refuge in arks, massive subterranean cryo shelters that would revive their occupants after the worst was over, so that they could start the process of rebuilding civilization. Those who could not were forced to face the brunt of the impact and then live on in the days after. You play as the sole survivor from one of those arcs, but you quickly realize that perhaps the worst is yet to come. The world is now occupied by those left behind, survivors both human and mutant, and their hardscrabble existence doesn't take kindly to newcomers. The gameplay of Rage centers entirely around the Wasteland, a massive expanse of land which is yours to explore, as well as your pathway towards specific indoor missions. These missions will offer up some pretty familiar shooter gameplay fare, with plenty of directed, close-quarters combat. It's not quite the fully open world you would get in a Grand Theft Auto style of game, but you have some choice in the missions that you do, and it's been hinted that your choices will affect the outcome in the game. Between missions, you'll be able to participate in vehicle races, compete in arena battles, hunt bandits in the wasteland, and go exploring for loot items, the latter of which will prove useful in Rage's crafting system. Don't worry though, you won't have to fuss over recipes, inventory lists, and encumbrance systems, but you might find that your stores of old rags and antiseptic can be turned into bandages to look after the wounds you're bound to incur out in the wastes. One of the first weapons you'll be introduced to in Rage is the Wing Stick, which is sort of a weaponized boomerang. The Wing Stick functions as both a ranged weapon and a silent weapon, so you can quietly dispatch enemies from afar. Early on, you'll also come across the Settler's Pistol, which affords a few choices in ammo types, a combat shotgun, and a semi-automatic assault rifle. Though later on, you'll be packing RPGs, machine guns, sniper rifles, and crossbows. Certainly an arsenal that would do fans of the studio proud. Combat in the game is pretty straightforward, but your enemies are anything but. Foes range from pale and malnourished bandits of the wasteland and massive lumbering super mutants to the well-equipped and powerful soldiers of the Authority, a highly organized military force attempting to wrest control of the wasteland. Rage will also feature both competitive and cooperative multiplayer modes, and the game's slant towards vehicle action will factor into both. One mode to look forward to is Combat Rally, a kill or be killed checkpoint-based race where you can win by being fast or by slowing down your opponents by filling them with lead. Either way, it's fine by the rules. One of the cooperative modes is called Titled Legends of the Wasteland. In this mode, you'll team up with a buddy and complete various missions that act as side stories to the missions you'll complete in the single-player campaign. Any new IP from id Software has some expectedly big shoes to fill, but Rage is shaping up to be a big enough package to fit the bill. With a massive new world to explore, filled with missions, enemies, and secrets to unearth, as well as a cooperative and competitive multiplayer modes, Rage looks like it has a lot to offer up. Be on the lookout for Rage when it releases on PC, PlayStation 3, and Xbox 360 on October 4th.